Coming up next is the UFC welterweight division matchup. Well, it seems an eventuality that Ben Askren would one day find his way to the UFC. Did that with a big win over Robbie Lawler in his UFC debut, and now the focus on continuing to climb that crowded welterweight ladder.
Ben Askren is a unique talent because he does not look like the type of guy that you would find in an octagon. But every time he steps foot in there, he has no doubt he's going to get his hand raised, which is what he has done his entire life. You look at Ben and you know what's coming. He's going to wrestle you. He's going to take you down. He's going to make you grapple more than you're comfortable with. But can Ben Askren employ that wrestling game plan all the way to a UFC championship? We will see.
Well, I'm excited for this one. This is a kickboxer of the highest order. He has so many different kicks and punches in his arsenal and figures to try to keep this on the feet here tonight.
The beautiful thing that he does is throws that front push kick to create distance when a guy starts to get too close and wants to wrestle with him. He throws it, and the moment you're back at his range, he starts to blast high kick. He doesn't always intend on landing it, but he beats up your arm with high kick after high kick after high kick. And as you get desperate, you start to run into knees, and he does not need much space to land a knockout punch. This guy is one of the best strikers we've ever seen in the UFC.
And if you don't find the striking range early against this guy, you could be in real trouble. Our tale of the tape for this welterweight fight. More than a decade separates these two fighters when it comes to the age, with similar height and reach. All right, now with the official introductions, we go inside the octagon of Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC welterweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 23 wins, 3 losses, and 1 no contest. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 170 pounds, Ben Funky! Introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 19 wins, no losses. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 170 pounds, fighting out of Los Angeles, California, the Executioner. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Eve Levine.
The veteran Eve Levine draws the assignment here.
You ready?
Well, it's good to see this man back inside the octagon. Round one getting underway here. As many of you know, he won his last fight by blistering knockout. His popularity has absolutely soared since. So with momentum tonight, he'll try to keep the winning streak and the knockout streak still intact. All right, going for the early takedown, and he gets it. So no surprise, he wanted to get this fight to the ground, and that is certainly a good sign for him moving forward in this fight.
He felt as if he had a massive advantage in the grappling and the wrestling. He was able to secure that takedown very early in the first round.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the defender.
Oh, he's back up again. You gotta like that.
Oh, he's hurt.
How about that shin? Oh! Huge right hand! His opponent squirming like a fish out of water now. The ground and pound is on point. This could very well be the beginning.
This could be the beginning of the end. We've seen some really good ground and pound fighters. This young man is as good as any we've ever seen. Now it's his moment.
Oh, and that is it. Referee has seen enough, and maybe so have we. Your winner by TKO.
That was a great performance. Way to land those strikes and go and chase down the finish when you get an opportunity.
let's re-rack the highlight now, DC, and he's certainly going to enjoy watching this one back. The head kick was there early, it was there often, and ultimately ended the night for his opponent.
He found a weakness in his opponent's game. The left kick, over and over, he was able to land it. And he was landing the strikes, too, with his hands, but ultimately, it was the kick that was hidden behind the punch that finished the fight for him.
All right, let's go inside the octagon where Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 2:02 of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, the Executioner.
Right, so there he is, the man of the hour. What a massive knockout for him.